First and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Bahasham, Wahar Rakar Kodash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and His Son's name is Yahweh Shai, and who we reverence and honor to the elder apostles of great millstone that taught me this truth, and those of you that are in the Holy Spirit, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few, brothers and sisters listening and learning in the hopes of being saved in these last days. Love not the world. Love not the world. Let's go to 1 John 2. I'm going to get straight to it. And 13. I have written unto you, fathers, because you have known him that is from the beginning. Is who Yahweh Shai. This would be referring to the elect. They've known Yahweh Shai from the beginning, because they were with Yahweh Shai from the beginning. I write unto you, young men, because you have overcome the wicked one. Right? So the elect, they've overcame what? The system. They've overcame the beast. I write unto you, little children, because you have known the Father. And I have written unto you, fathers, because you've known him that is from the beginning. I have written unto you, young men, because you are strong. Strong in what? The words. And the word of the Most High abideth in you, and you have overcome the wicked one. So the elect is saying, they've already overcome the wicked one, but I just need to replay that in the flesh. So that means they overcame this world. They overcame the system. They were not held back by it. This is verse 15. Love not the world. The scriptures say, when I first heard this scripture, massive weight off my shoulders. Because remember, there's with the world comes expectations. People look at you a certain way. Oh, how come you ain't got Prada? How come you ain't got Nike? How come you ain't got this? How come you ain't got a nice car? How come you ain't got a wife, big house? Love not the world. So when you read these scriptures, that's a huge weight off your shoulders. Because now the expectations of the world and what the world thinks doesn't matter. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. And that's very, for some people, that'd be very harsh. If any man love this world, so if any man has an affinity, a love, deep down, he really loves this world, that means you don't want this world to go down. So how could you really be against the wickedness? If you deep down you really love this world, how could you be against the wickedness? That would make you a hypocrite. That would make you a fake. That would make you phony. How could you say you hate the world, but you're of the world? Obviously, we're in the world, but you're of the world. So how can you really hate this world? So if you're of this world, that means you're an enemy of Yahweh Shai, that means you're an enemy of his servants. If any man love the world, and that's why certain men that are of the world, they end up coming up against men that are not of the world. Why? Because that's that fight between what? The righteous and the wicked. The love of the Father is not in him. So if you love this world, the love of the Father, Yahweh, is not in you. Because he's going to destroy this world with fire. Verse 16, for all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh. And when people think, a carnal man would just think, alright, you're gazing at a big booty woman. No, it's not just that, the lust of the flesh, okay, which comes with the world. You want to get a nice car. Lust of the flesh, not as long as getting a car, but you understand what I'm saying? You out there chasing after women, lust of the flesh. You chasing after money, lust of the flesh. These are all lust of the flesh. You envying, that's a lust of the flesh. These are the spirits of the world. And the lust of the eyes, because this world, what is it set up to? To captivate you what? And your lower nature. To captivate your lower nature. So you can't really tap in and be spiritual. That's how this world is set up. To keep you on a low, low, low frequency. Not to keep you spiritual. And the pride of life. The pride of life is like that. The mobile Facebook type of spirit, you know, Twitter, you know, all that, that's the pride of life. MTV, that's the pride of life. It's not of the Father, but it's of the world. So that spirit is of the world. Comparing. You know, comparing one another to each other. I can do this, I can do that. That's the spirit of the world. Envy and jealousy, that's the spirit. These are all spirits of the world, and the world passeth away. This world, this rulership is going to pass away. And when you go into that word world, it's cosmos and it's Titan. The word cosmos is what an arrangement and an age. And this age is going to pass away. Okay, this is a disarrangement of things is going to pass away. This is arrangement of things is going to pass away. That's what. That's where. Why we wait upon Yahweh Shai, right? Wait upon Him. And it says, and the world passes away, and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of the Most High abideth forever. So it's about doing the will of Yahweh Shai. Those that are doing His will, they're going to abide. They're going to abide in what? The Word. So now let's go to Peter. 2 Peter 2 and 20. For if they had escaped the pollutions of the world, so you have individuals that were coming to the truth. Okay. But they go right back in, right back into the world. So you've escaped those pollutions. And when you go into the pollutions, what is the pollution? Okay, quickly type in that word.
Miasma.
That which defiles, a defilement. That's how you're defiled. You're defiled by this world. Because this world is against Yahweh Shai. That's why Yahweh Shai, what did he say? Deuteronomy 7 and 6. You are a holy people. Holy means separate. So he separates you. His men, he's going to separate them from this world. So they cannot be defiled with this world. That which defiles defilement, metaphor of vices. Vices what? The flesh. Okay, that's what we want, it's the flesh. The foulness of which contaminates one in his intercourse with the ungodly mass of mankind. So you join yourself together with this world. What does it say? It contaminates one. That's that defilement. Someone that's of this world. Okay? Misyama, motherly foulness effect, pollution. And that's where you're polluting. Okay? And you Yahweh Shai ain't going to beam up anyone that wants to be drunk with this world. Because if you're drunk with this world, that means you're at one with this world. Right? That means you're at one with what? The beast. The whole point of coming into truth is repenting, begging for mercy from Yahweh Shai, and hoping for salvation. And that was it. Not to be draped into this world. Right? And the pollutions of the world through the knowledge of the Lord Yahweh Shai Mashiach. So when you hear about this truth, you escape those pollutions of the world. How are you living in the world? Through the knowledge of the Lord Yahweh Shai Mashiach, Yahweh Shai. That's why the knowledge of Yahweh Shai is so important. Okay? For the knowledge of Yahweh Shai is going to keep you away from the world. Where you're again entangled therein. Okay? So you have men, they come to truth, but then they become entangled back into the world. And it says, and overcome, the latter end is worse than the beginning. With them in the beginning, so they're in a worse state. And you may ask, well, how are they in a worse state? Well, all you would need to do is just examine the matter. Examine their spirit. Examine how they were when they first started, how they are now. That's why it says the latter end is worse with them than the beginning. They're in a worse state. It bugged out. Okay? Different countenance changes, everything. And I've done videos about this, warning brothers, just like, stay focused on Yahweh Shai. And if you miss a day, 2 days, make up for them 2 days by doing more. This is working off, it had been better for them not to have known the way. It was better for you not to even know the truth. Not even, to even know the name. You see how harsh these scriptures can be. Of righteousness, the path of righteousness ran after they have known it to turn from the holy commandment, determined what to pervert, to go aside, delivered unto them, that it is happened unto them according to the true proverb, the dog is turned to his own vomit. Okay, and that's what you've seen it when dogs vomit and they eat up their vomit, that's disgusting. So you turn back to what you were doing in the world. You will turn back to that old nigger. That's why the scriptures put off the old man from day to day. That's there's supposed to be a change. And the soul that was washed in her wallowing in Ramah. It's like you getting in mud, getting out of the mud, getting in the shower, but you're going back into that mud, that dung. That's what it's likened unto. That's why you got cleave unto Yahabai Sham Yahabashai. Hope this is edifying. This is not a joke. I've seen it. I've witnessed this. There's no reason I'm just saying this for no reason. I've seen men have this spirit upon them, really enjoy this truth, then to go back into the world because they couldn't, they couldn't separate. They didn't know how to separate the worldly things from the truth. They didn't know how to separate it. Why? Because they were never given time for the Holy Spirit. They were never given it that time. It was just something to do on Saturdays. But the rest of the week, they wasn't living it. They were speaking, but they were not living it. This is serious. And it says, entangled, his last state is worse. Now let's go to Luke 11 and 26, Baruch Hashem. Alright? Let's go to Luke 11 and 26. In just a minute. Serious, and yes, I'm speaking from experience because I've labored with individuals that came into the truth somewhat passionate, but they could not separate the world. They could not be that because they never made time for the spirit. They never made time for Yahabashai. So if you don't make time for him, it's like, well, why do I need you? Why do I need to use your vessel to push my word? That's how it works. Let's go to Luke 11 and 26. Then he's just going to Luke 11. It's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of Yahweh. So let's go to Luke 11 and 26. He that is not with me. So if you're not with Yahweh Shai, is against me. So if you're not with Yahweh Shai, you're against him. You can't be double-minded. You can't have one foot in the world, one foot in the truth. You have a four, you have a shade, his word, and you're against him. And he that gathereth not with me, scattereth. So are you gathering? Are you actually gathering? Are you scattering? And scattering, you were confusing people. Because yes, we know there's agents of provocateurs, there's wicked men, there's demons in the truth. Their whole thing is to scatter, to cause confusion. But the Lord's going to search them out. And that's why the scriptures tell you in John 10 and 10. Okay? The thief come but not what to steal and kill and to destroy. Yeah, that goes for our own people as well. The thief cometh in some other way. And when the unclean spirit is gone out of a man, so here we go. Walking through dry places. So that unclean spirit was that spirit, the wicked spirit you had when you first came into the truth, when you first heard about it. But it went, it left. And how did it leave? Through the word. How shall a man cleanse his way? By washing the water by the word. And he walking through dry places, seeking rest. So that spirit, that wicked spirit that left, is always seeking an entry. Always. That's the old man. The old man will always invite you back. The old man's always got a place for you. Okay, you want to come back to the world? That's why you've got to be strong and find none. He saith. And this is speaking about a spirit. So it's actually a spirit. That old man that left you, that spirit is always waiting. In other words, Satan's always waiting to get back up in that vessel. And he saith, I will return unto my house whence I came up. So what's that house? And about your flesh. So how can that spirit return you? The only how the spirit that wicked spirit can return is if you ain't been in the Word, if you ain't been focusing on the Word. And when he cometh, he findeth it swept and gone. So if something's swept and gone, it's cleaned out. That means this truth is no longer in your mind. That means this truth has been swept and it's no longer in your mind. And this is what happens. And you find it swept and garnished, emptied out. And that's what happens when you go, like, 2 days is fine. But when it gets to a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, then there's something definitely wrong. If you're not reading, if you're not watching any videos, well, what do you think is going to happen? Satan's always looking for that opening to get back in there. Right? And that shows you what he also deals with, what the mind. Then he goeth and taketh him 7 other spirits more wicked. And 7 other spirits, look, that's double. That's triple. Which are what? Legions. So now legions all up in your what? Your inward parts. And that's why I say men have demons all up in their inward parts. Right? And when he cometh, he findeth it swept and garnished. Then he goeth and taketh to him 7 other spirits. Why? Because that first spirit invited his bodies. Because there was no defense. And the scriptures tell you that as well. A man that have no ruler over his spirit is like a city that is broken down without walls. Any madness can get in. Then the next thing, you be what, following Christianity, Darwinism, all that rubbish. Other spirits more wicked than himself. So that's 7, so it's going to be overcome. And that's why it's 7 Peter. So that first state is worse than the last. The last state of that man was worse than the first, and they enter him. Okay? And they grow them. Okay? You know that game ping pong? The pinball game. That's what them demons are doing. And they grow there. They grow in your mind, and the last state of that man is worse than the first. That's why the scripture says, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. And you could warn individuals about this. For years. Then you see these things play out and it's like, whoa. Whoa. And that's why I moved to the fear of Yahweh. I was trying to do this work. Because I've seen what can happen when you're not focused about this, when you're not sincere. First hand. A man can wake up the next day and say, I don't believe anymore. I've seen it. You've had men that have done, I'm not going to mention their names, but you've had men that done that. And for some reason, these injuries, they're not mentioned. Okay, and a lot of men sided with other men that went right back into the world because they're wicked themselves. They're of the world themselves. Let's go to Matthew 6:22. The light of the body is the eye. Okay, your mind is that eye. The single, which is your mind's eye, the whole body shall be full of light. So single, you're focused. You're focused on the mission at hand. You're focused on salvation. The focus on getting out of here. The whole body's going to be what? Full of light. Because you're going to be what? Endowed with what? More wisdom and understanding. Your mind ain't going to be here. Okay. Oh man. Bear with just a minute. These lessons have to be done. Bear with just a minute. It's about making the effort. Even when you're feeling tired, okay? I'm feeling tired. But guess what? You push through. And that's how that increasement is given to you. Because the other side sees that you're making an effort. Let's go to verse 23. But if the eye be evil, the whole body shall be full of darkness. And this is what's happened. I've said this many times. This is what has happened. Now you've got a bunch of, I shouldn't generalize, but you have a bunch of now zombies. Men with wicked ass spirits on them in the truth. Do we get attacked? Yes, but what's the main defense? This word. But now you have men that are overcome. They're not even fighting, they're just overcome by them spirits. But if the eye be evil, so guess what? The eye, mind. So now you've got men in the truth, pushing the truth, that they have an evil eye towards their brother. And they actually think they're going to be saved. The whole body shall be full of darkness. So guess what? You're going to have a dark countenance. You're going to have them dark eyes, black bags underneath your eyes. And if therefore the light that is in you is darkness, how great is that darkness? And that darkness is the world. That's what that darkness is. So how do we get away from the darkness? By being in the street. Therefore, for no man can serve two masters, he will either hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve the Most High and mammon. Don't want to be in that spirit. I don't know. You don't choose for you. How shall I walk? He choose for you. I've always said this. Ecclesiastes 33:27. Send him to labor, that he be not idle. For idleness teaches much evil. So there's the thing again. If you're idle in the word, if you're not really focused on the word, of course it's going to teach much evil, because now the Satan is going to use that as an advantage. Oh, well, he's not studying. You know, let me get up in there. Okay? And again, brothers, we do things in our downtime. Even within our downtime, the scriptures should still be on your mind. You're watching a movie. You're still filtering that movie through the scriptures. You're going somewhere. You're going to a restaurant. You're taking your woman out. Whatever. You're still looking around you and filtering things through the scriptures. Right? When Yahweh Shai was the word, he was the word because everything he saw around him, what was he doing? Exercising the word. He was the word. So with us, with this truth, we want to exercise the word. Even when you don't have a Bible with you, you're out, you're looking at things, and what? You're applying the scriptures with it, and linking it up, right? So with this lesson, I hope this is edifying, and until the next time, shalom to the hopeful elect.